conservation of wild life species, conservation of wild life. For example, first as a demarcation of bioreserves. Government is delimiting the some of the forest lands protected for wildlife species of animals. For example, national parks, those protected forest lands which are preferably used for a protection of a wildlife species. In such forest lands, animals living at their natural habitats and human interferences allow. Human interference means as a tribals, they can go for a collection of a fuel wood. Tribal communities, they can go in a national parks for a collection of a fuel wood or the desired items. They can go for a cultivation also in a national parks. Those protected areas where wildlife species of animals living at their natural habitats. Example, their examples are Sariska in Rajasthan, Sariska in Rajasthan, Dudhwa in Uttar Pradesh, third, Jim Corbett in Uttarakhand, Jim Corbett in Uttarakhand, Jim Corbett in Uttarakhand, Kanheri in Maharashtra, Gir Forest in Gujarat, which is considered as a home of a Gir Forest in Gujarat, considered as a home of a Asiatic lion, Periyar in Kerala, Simlipal in Orissa, all these are the examples of a national parks. Dudhwa, I'm again repeating, as a Sariska in a Rajasthan, which is known as a home of a black buck. The conspiracy has related with the killing of a black buck by the Salman Khan, related with the Sariska National Park of Rajasthan. Dudhwa in Uttar Pradesh, Corbett in Uttarakhand, Kanheri in Maharashtra, Gir in Gujarat, Periyar in Kerala, Simlipal in Orissa. These are the examples of national parks. Those protected lands where wildlife species of animals living at their natural habitats. Second type of the bioreserves are wildlife sanctuaries. Wildlife sanctuaries are those protected forests or protected lands which are used to protection of endangered species of animals. In such areas, as a human interference not allowed. In such number of areas, human interference is not allowed. Example, Dachigam in J&K. In J&K, Rajaji in Uttarakhand. Rajaji in Uttarakhand. Kanha in Madhya Pradesh. Kanha in Madhya Pradesh. Manas and Kaziranga in Assam. Kaziranga in Assam are some of the examples of wildlife sanctuaries. Wildlife sanctuaries, those protected lands which are used to protect the endangered species of animals. Endangered species of animals. Endangered species of animals are the wildlife sanctuaries. Clear? These are the wildlife species of animals. Wildlife species of animals. Kanha in Madhya Pradesh. K-A-N-H-A. Kanha in Madhya Pradesh. I'm again repeating as a Dachigam in Jammu and Kashmir. At the north of India, Rajaji in Uttarakhand. Rajaji in Uttarakhand. Kanha in Madhya Pradesh. Manas in Assam and Kaziranga in Assam. Manas and Kaziranga, these are used to for the rhinos, protection of a rhinos, rhinoceros. Protection of rhinos. Clear? Next, third type of the bioreserves are bird sanctuaries. These are known as the bird sanctuaries. Bird sanctuaries. Those protected lands which are used for a protection of a birds, especially as a migratory birds. Manas in Assam, Pranay. So those protected lands used for a protection of a birds, especially as a migratory birds. Migratory birds. Such migratory birds, they are coming towards India. They are coming towards India for a breeding. For breeding. They are coming towards India for breeding. Example, Bharatpur in Rajasthan. Bharatpur in Rajasthan. Bharatpur in Rajasthan. In Rajasthan. And second, Chilika, Odisha. In Odisha, these two bird sanctuaries are used for a protection of birds, especially for a protection of birds. Protection of birds. Clear? Protection of birds. So these are the bioreserves which are used for a protection of a wildlife species of animals. Wildlife. Protect wildlife species of animals. It's a 9th class. Kerala, Pranay. Periyar in Kerala. It's also a bird sanctuary. It's also a bird sanctuary. I'm just giving as a limited number of examples to you. Rest of the things we will mark in a map. Clear? So these are the bioreserves. Second effort done by the Government of India in relation to the protection of a wildlife species, in relation to wildlife species of animals, for which as a Wildlife Protection Act, Wildlife Protection Act enacted by the Government of India in 1972. In 1972, it has been adopted by all the states. All the states as strictly followed as the Wildlife Protection Act, means as hunting banned in our country. Hunting of wildlife species of animals is banned in our country. It governs this Wildlife Protection Act of 1972. It governs the wildlife conservation and protection of endangered species. Protection of endangered species. This act prohibits the trade in rare and endangered species. This Wildlife Protection Act prohibits trade of animal parts like as a skin, tusk of elephants, horns of rhinos. Clear such kind of the animal parts, wildlife animals parts are, their trade is prohibited in our country as according to the Wildlife Protection Act. Wildlife Protection Act. Clear? Third, in relation to the protection of a wildlife species, Government of India initiated the National Wildlife Action Plan. National Wildlife Action Plan, which provides a network of programs or a framework of strategies as well as programs conservation of wildlife. It initiated in 1983. National Wildlife Action Plan initiated in 1983. It initiated in 1983 and revised in 2002. According to this plan, according to this National Wildlife Action Plan to increase the total number of protected areas as 103 national parks and 535 centuries covering a vast surface area for protection of wildlife species. Fourth, Project Tiger, Project Rhino initiated to increase total strength of such wildlife species, increase percentage of such wildlife species at their natural habitats. Fifth, special efforts are being made to preserve endangered species, periodic census are undertaken to check their presence in national parks and wildlife sanctuaries, their presence in national parks and wildlife species, sorry, wildlife sanctuaries, their presence in national parks and wildlife sanctuaries. Next, sixth, a major initiative to include the environmental education, EVS, which you read in a previous classes in your third, fourth, and fifth, environmental education as a separate and compulsory subject, separate and compulsory subject in the educational curriculum, educational curriculum has been taken up by the government at all levels of formal education. If a person is pursuing their graduation, for which has also the environmental studies, that subject has to clear. It's mandatory for all, compulsory for all. That examination of environmental studies, it has to clear by the individual which are taking as admissions in a graduations. Bachelors of Arts, Bachelors of Sciences and Commerce. They have to clear that examination. This is as a mandatory due to as the efforts of a government at all levels, secondary, senior secondary and university level. I'm again repeating as a sixth point, a major initiative to include the environmental education as a separate and compulsory subject in the educational curriculum, which has been taken up by the government at all levels of formal education, that is the secondary, senior secondary and college education. Clear? So this was our chapter, Natural Vegetation and Wildlife. Any doubts, any questions? Any questions in your side related with this chapter, Natural Vegetation and Wildlife? Next part is the exercise. Multiples of seven, raise your hands. Yes, Arun, what happened? Lakshya, fifth point, it was special efforts taken by the, these were being made by the government of India, in which as a timely census conducted to know about the existence of a wildlife species. Census means official counting for a such species of endangered species which are living at their natural habitats, their presence counted to the census, for which as the yearly or annual census, annual counting as a conducted by the government of India, through which they can put their efforts for a conservation of a wildlife species. Clear, Laksh? So the exercise, I think multiples of seven, all these are absent. Question number one, to which one of the following types of vegetation does rubber belong to? It's a tropical evergreen forest, which has required more than 200 centimeters annual rainfall. Tropical evergreen forest. First D, tropical evergreen forest. Second, Cinchona trees are found in areas of a rainfall more than 100 centimeters. 100 centimeters. Second A. Third, in which of the following state is the Simlipal Bioreserve situated? Odisha. It's in Odisha. Which one of the following bioreserves of India is not included in a world network of bioreserves is a Manas. M-A-N-A-S. M-A-N-A-S. Question number two. What factors are responsible for a distribution of plants and animals in India? Different types of precipitation. Precipitation occur in areas. Rainfall occurred in areas. Second, as temperature. Third, land. Land. For example, in a mountain vegetation, we discuss as a till height of 1000 meters as tropical deciduous forest. In dry climatic conditions, favorable for tropical deciduous forest. In a wet climatic conditions, for example, as a terrain regions of a Piedmont areas of mountains, favorable for a tropical evergreen forest. Above the height of 1000 meters towards 3000 meters as a coniferous forests are growing. 3000 meters towards 3500 as a alpine vegetation. Afterwards, the 3500 towards the 5000 meters, there are the grasses and the shrubs are possible to grow due to as a low temperature conditions. But above the height of 5000 meters, not possible for a growth of a vegetation because of snow-fed areas. Snow has existing in such areas as throughout the year. That's why as a not favorable conditions for a growth of a vegetation. Third point, as a land, you have to write only as a heading there. Land, precipitation, temperature, soils, S-O-I-L-S, S-O-I-L-S, soils. And one more, sunlight, photoperiod. Second, as a what is a bioreserve? Bioreserves are those protected lands where wildlife species of animals living at their natural habitats. Wildlife species of animals living at their natural habitats. Examples, any two examples you can note it down. As an example, either from a national parks, wildlife sanctuaries or bird sanctuaries. You can write about the Dachigam, Sariska, Rajaji, Corbett, Dudhwa, Kanha, Kaneri, Periyar, Simlipal, Manas, Kaziranga, any one of it, Sundarbans. Any two examples which are easier for you. Bioreserves are those protected lands where the wildlife species of animals living at their natural habitats. Clear? Any two examples with it. Name two animals having as a habitat in a tropical vegetation. In tropical vegetation as a monkeys, elephants, tiger. They are living in a tropical conditions. Monkeys, elephant, tigers, they are preferably living in a tropical conditions, whereas a mountain type of vegetation, snow leopard, panda, yak, clear? Snow leopard, panda, Himalayan panda, P-A-N-D-A, Himalayan panda, snow leopard, yak, they are available, they are present, they can survive in a cold weather conditions. Next, as a distinguishing between a flora and fauna, flora denotes as a plant species, fauna denotes as an animal species. So distinguish as tropical evergreen and tropical deciduous. You have to differentiate on behalf of a rainfall receiving in both the conditions, tropical evergreen and tropical deciduous, the number types of a species of animals, second point. Third point, as a trees, the species of trees growing, they can as possible to grow in a tropical evergreen and tropical deciduous. Your third point, it should be as a species of trees can grow in a both the types of vegetation. Fourth, it should be as the meaning of their names. Tropical evergreen, those forests which do not shed their leaves in a particular months of the year, they can remain green throughout the year. Tropical evergreen, that's why they are known as a tropical evergreen. Tropical deciduous forests are those which are shedding their leaves before of winters, in a particular months of the year before winters, during the autumn time period. Clear? Tropical evergreen and tropical deciduous. And fifth point, it should be as a the quality, importance of a vegetation. Tropical evergreen vegetation is known for the hardwood, which is as a less used for a commercial purposes. But as compared to this, tropical deciduous forest, known for a growth of a softwood, which is as required for a timber industry, for furnitures. Clear? Question number four, name different types of vegetation found in India and describe the vegetation. All the five categories of vegetation, you have to write the names of all the five types of vegetation, types of vegetation, then the explain only one as a mountain vegetation. Mountainous vegetation you have to explain. Fifth question, as a quite a few species of plants and animals are endangered. Regions, what are the reasons? Loss of habitats. First point, as a loss of habitats. Forest lands are cleared for a commercialization of agriculture for due to as a growth of industries and urbanization, expansion of cities. Cities are presently as occupying the agricultural land. So the agriculture land, the necessity of agriculture land obtained through the forest lands, for which as a forests are cleared in a larger scale. A large scale of a developmental projects like as a dams, construction of dams are also responsible for a clearing of a forest. So first as a loss of habitats, second as human predation, second reason responsible for a species of a plants and animals which becomes as endangered as human predation, human activities which leads to the decreasing the wildlife species of animals and plants, human predation, hunting and poaching, illegal smuggling of a body parts of animals responsible for the illegal smuggling of body parts of animals, skin, tusk, teeth, horns, skulls. These kind of the materials are exported in a world market as illegally, which has led to the becoming the such number of wildlife species which are becoming as endangered. Third, as a pesticides and pollution. Third reason, as a excessive use of pesticides, which leads to the death of animals because are present agriculture based upon a genetically modified seeds and pesticides. These are used in a larger scale in our agriculture practices. It has adversely impact over environment. With the increasing the pollution, a large number of species of birds, they are reaching at a level of extinction. They are becoming as endangered, as some of them are extinct from the environment, like dodo, D-O-D-O, dodo. Clear? And last question, question number six, why has India a rich heritage of flora and fauna? The factors responsible for the different kinds of vegetation in India. Different kinds of vegetation in India. On your notebooks, you have to attempt the question number 2, 4, 5, and 6. 2, 4, 5, and 6. Question number 2, answer the questions briefly. Question number 4, long question. 5, 6, both are the long questions. You have to attempt on your notebooks. Clear? Attempt on your notebooks. And today is a Monday. Your copies, it should be as a ready till next Monday. Copies, it should be ready till next Monday. Yes, you?
सर आपने पिछले दो मिनट में क्या बोला सर मेरा ऑडियो डिस्कनेक्ट हो गया था
यू हैव टू अटेम्प्ट अ क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, 4, 5, 6 ऑन योर नोटबुक्स 2, 4, 5, 6 ऑन योर नोटबुक्स क्लियर क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, 4, 5, 6 ऑन योर नोटबुक्स टिल मंडे योर कॉपी इट शुड बी रेडी क्लियर सो एनी क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड विद द नेचुरल वेजिटेशन एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ Natural vegetation and wildlife. Yes, Dharin.
सर फ्लोरा और फौना में डिफरेंसेस क्या हो सकते हैं?
उसे छोड़ दो
सर.
यस सो आई थिंक नथिंग हैज अ मीनिंग इन दिस चैप्टर. नेक्स्ट चैप्टर हैज अ पॉवर्टी फ्रॉम इकोनॉमिक्स. इन दीज मार्च एग्जामिनेशंस दे विल बी एज अ फोर चैप्टर्स. वन एज अ ड्रेनेज, सेकंड क्लाइमेट, थर्ड नेचुरल वेजिटेशन एंड फोर्थ one chapter from economics. Poverty. poverty is a situation in which a person poverty is a situation in which a person is unable to get minimum basic necessities of life, that is food, shelter, clothing. When a person unable to complete their basic needs, food, shelter and clothing for his or her sustain is known as a poverty. It is known as the poverty. Poverty is a state or a situation in which a person is unable to get their minimum basic needs, that is food, shelter, clothing. After the 70 years of Indian independence, the trend of poverty is declining at present. At the time of our independence, there were more than 50% of population living under poverty, which were unable to complete their basic needs. India, it was as a poorer country at the time of the partition. But afterwards, when the planning commission set up in 1950, government initiated as the sectoral growth of economy, which visualized as the trend of a poverty declining. Presently, as a still 27 to 29% population is still under the poverty at present. Tomorrow we will